Alright, yeah, okay, so I know the last video was all happy, happy. Come on, we can just, you know, think out of it. But yeah, I'm feeling really dejected. I'm feeling like this entire process has been like, what is it, when you fall into a slumber and you just can't get out, and a big foot, a Republican foot is just smashing all of the liberals, a big one, and across the entire United States, and you know, the certain states that held up, you know, the certain ones that held up so strong are feeling as clustered little islands of only there you can live as a liberal, only there you can breathe as a liberal. All the other places you would feel hunted, you know, hunted as an enemy, you know, surrounded by the others, you know. It's quite a point blank, you know, like let's say I lived in Wyoming today, I would feel like I had rifles and whatever they have, cannons pointed at me. I would want to escape immediately. I'd want to get on the first little bus, the first little car, the first way out. I'm shocked as heck that that could happen, that you could have that type of dissidence and disagreement. Get them out, like there's some kind of evil witches, some kind of Salem. Salem, get them up and drown them, going on. I'm not happy with the outcome at all. It should have been a better fight, much better fight. Way too much Republican going on. And the scariness is when you hit the House and you hit the Senate, and it's straight on through, Republican wins. So when you have the House and the Senate, Republican wins, and the presidency, you're looking at, well, the Republicans don't have to speak much for the next 4 years, they don't have to do much. They can just blink their eyes and go, yay. Now, the workers have to be the Democrats. They have to be the convincers. They have to get in there and jive them around and prod them and say, come on, try this side this time around. You know, think my way a little bit. So the big work has to come from the Democrats, little and small group as they are. You know, when they've won, you know, they won across the board on everything. House of Representatives, the Senate, and the Presidency. Alright, so now what does that mean for... Wow, hello, I'm on a stranded island. I don't even want to tiptoe across Nevada. I don't trust them, I don't care if they've legalized marijuana. I don't trust them. I don't trust any of you people that are so die-hard Republican. There's something wrong with you that you wouldn't even want to be a sway state. There's something wrong with you that you wouldn't even want to be maybe 55 to 45. There's something wrong with you. If your state is that disparate, it is 60% to 30 or 70% to 30. Forget the Green Party. If you're that disparate, then that is a bushel of money that the United States government should never be able to spend on your state, because your state has some kind of what do you call it, a roundabout leaning that is unjust. It's unjust. It's obviously being manipulated. Manipulatable group, a group of people manipulating the entire population of that state. and they're probably getting money from the government to do it. So yeah, it's a very, very bad situation when you have that type of disparity. Should never have gone on like that. So anyway, yeah, it's kind of depressing. It's really depressing. I don't know why the liberals had to be kicked so hard. I don't think that was necessary. It was never necessary. Anyway, I really wanted to not even talk about this ridiculous election. I will put that brief image up at the beginning, though, to just show you, hey, I guess it's safe to live there on those little blue spots on the planet. It's safe to live there. Because I do feel like, yeah, that would be a gang of people against me. Absolutely. All right, so now when you have that going on, my gosh, do we have to start making pledges? Forget muscular dystrophy. We need pledges to free the liberals out of these Republican states. Maybe they're not feeling safe, especially women. If there are liberal women that are alone and they're in the middle of these Republican diehard states, how do we get them out? How do we get them out of there? How about that? How about that? So let's make that non-profit. Let's bring that one up and perhaps throw a little bit of money you have extra to bring some of those women over here, bring them over to the liberal states. And we now have them pinned on the map. It's quite clear. Yeah. So we'll get our supporters and bring them back. I don't know what else to do. When there's that much of a separation, when there's that much of a divide, it is a serious, unsafe, for a woman. It's a serious unsafe. So, yeah, we're talking about the war in America. That's it. You got it. Anyway, I can go on. I wanted to talk a little bit about the arts and how they're affected by this. This election. I don't see a big money swaying going on, just because it's a Republican era. I don't see that's going to be happening. I'll bring you a brief little here it is. A brief little escapade of where I used to work. Anyway, let's see. Yeah. Anyway, so it's a beautiful theater. And that's the deal. You know, when you think about the arts, and you think about dancing, you think about ballet, it's not ever that here in America now, is it? I can't even tilt it right. Yeah, it's not this in America. And unfortunate beggars they are here in America, isn't it? They're unfortunate beggars for the arts. Normally, the liberal side, the Democrats, are quite supportive of the arts, normally. So this is could be a big throw, a big hurt. Maybe classical ballet is this. We'll get a good, a good boost. Maybe classical. So it's going to be a real pure classical embellish. But it's never going to be this. It's just not. They've trained the people away from the arts. They've taken them out of school. They don't have the arts in school. They've taken extra languages out of school. They've taken all of these things that they create an international human being. They've taken that away. You know, it's created a practical tiny civil war state between Republicans and Democrats. Instead of culture. And so instead of, hey, this is America, we build culture. We want this for our theaters. We want our theaters to look like this. We can build them like this. Why do I have to go travel on the airplane by myself, become a little ballerina there, to be there, and dance there? Why do I have to go that far away? Why couldn't I have done this here in America? Anyhoots. Yeah, so, when you tossed out the liberals are here doing this. The liberals. Anyway, so I don't know. I'm kind of bummed out. I don't know what to do about this whole situation. It wasn't a good fight. It was a fight that was just stupid, and it didn't amount to anything. They didn't even know who Hillary Clinton was, maybe, half the people. And, you know, that's the way it goes. So anyway, I'm starting to look at the fear state that they've created for the liberals, especially liberal women. I don't like the yee-haw Republican male. I think he can go to hell. And unfortunately, he sure does live all across America in those red states. So yeah. So is there, what do we call that? At the end of the game, you know, the rats, and you're like, oh my gosh, I got to get on the rock, get at top of the maze, away from all of the, you know, the riffraff. Well, it's getting tough. It's getting tough. You know, I thought we had a bigger maze, a bigger hedge to stand upon. As liberals, we do not have that. And then I'm like, well, I'm mad at myself. Maybe I should have done more. I should have been out here more. I should have talked more. I should have been more explique on, hey, this is what's going to happen. This is going to hit us. You know, maybe y'all just don't get it. You know. So we're left with Western states and a few other over there in the East, but we're left over here with these Western states, which are difficult. They're not easy states to live in. Anyway, I'm not a happy person today. It's because it's difficult. It's a difficult walk forward, isn't it? It's a difficult walk forward when you already know you're just going to be jilted at every turn for at least the next 4 years. You know, I raise my hand to say, you know, so it's a political journey that's just going to be just, what? You spoke? And you're a Democrat? No, I didn't hear you. I just didn't hear you. So how convenient. Whoever invented this, that there would be, you know, a possibility for an all-Republican rule. Very bad design for a government. Should never have allowed that. Anyway, so, hands tied, liberals, for the next 4 years. Gee whiz. At least we have the free internet. We can talk here on the YouTube or whatever. Whoopee. Whoopee, everybody. I don't know. I'm sorry. I don't have a better answer. I don't have an answer. It just feels like a fail, an abysmal fail. Dang it. We don't have this. We don't even have a voice in the political regular 4 years. We don't have this or a voice. Just awful. Just gosh dang awful. So we can go over to the Stromat Peninsula there, whatever, in India, and we can look at them and go, well, I thought they were a little bit out there, a little bit overdone, trying to find attainment. But yeah, it takes my mind off of this ridiculous show. The ridiculous show of politics, of the no, for a liberal. Yeah, they're allowed still to be there in India like that. As crazed as they are, and obsessed as they are to find their enlightenment, and to get on their train, their channel to it. Yeah, they're allowed that there. I don't know this liberal, this unliberal group here, a Republican style. I don't know if they would allow those Stromat yogis to be here in America acting so free with themselves. Yeah, I don't know. I don't think it's really a great example. I'm not happy with him either. That's another extreme. Way too far extreme. I'm not sure why that was necessary to go for Enlightenment Channel that way. I know, it's all transic, they're on their transic, they're on their meditations, I don't know, I just think they've gone too far. But what's the other side? What's the other side now? I don't know. Hee-haw, let's go and get some ribs. I just don't like this situation. I don't find an answer happening. Not even this. We can't even get this happening, you know. I don't know. It's too sad. It's too sad. I have a feeling the rest of the world also is going, oh, America, well. I don't know. It's a political system that's just not fast enough, first of all. Doesn't happen fast enough. And the chance for the flow back, again, oh, bring that up again, you know, it's just like, ugh, yeah, halt the brakes, again. Anyhoot. How does that affect everything? How does that affect anything? I don't know. I'm just gonna play my drums for a while and start my little drum shop, sound shop, and give some sounds away. They're sounding a little funky. They're a little pingy. But I don't know. Something to take my mind away. But you know, if we do more meditations out there, I see the meditation channel people, let's meditate more, and maybe that's it, you know. Maybe that's all we can do, is take over the world with a bunch of meditation channels. And what will they do? They can close down YouTube, they meditate too much. I don't know. Maybe I can just, what do I have to do? Give people gumption to speak, as a liberal on this device machine called the internet. Maybe we can win that way. I don't know. When I think win, you know, I mean win with just simple popular opinion. How about that? Simple popular opinion. Yeah, hello, are we even vegetarians anymore? Is that legal? It's just a halt, isn't it? It's just a halt feeling.